audience. He probably bumps into duchesses everywhere he goes. He's done it for everyone. He is amazing. Please welcome to the stage of the Richfield Playhouse, the London Medium, Mr. Bernard Elsley.
Front of me, that's what it is. That can happen sometimes. So, alright, so two Michaels, is there an initial A amongst all of that somewhere as well?
My father.
Your father?
Alan. Yeah, just passed.
Alan. Yeah, and he's just got into spirit too. So, there's only one Michael in spirit though, that I can tell, right? And one Alan, the other Michael's still here. That's the way I'm getting it. I feel your dad, Alan, he's taking care of, he calls him little Michael. But he was bigger than him, Mikey, right?
Yes.
And he called him little Mikey, but Mikey was tall, right?
Yeah.
And he was also, was it an accident with we'll call him little Mikey even though he's tall? Was it an accident with him? Because I feel a sudden passing into the spirit. It was just sudden, right? Very sudden, unexpected, because he wasn't a very big age, was he?
28.
28, that's right. No age, really. No age, right? He's saying to me that there's a girl that tries to... She gives him flowers very regularly.
His girlfriend, he was so in love with
her. Yeah, keeps going to his place of rest with the flowers, yes, and giving her the flowers. And he's like, he gets kind of very touched by it, you know. It's like, he feels like she's there talking to him and he's saying, I don't know what to do about it, you know. And Alan, he's trying to console him a bit because he's upset about it. He keeps saying, look, well, you know, there's nothing you can do about it, Sam. You know, it's like, you know, she will eventually find it easier. But the good news is, he's coming today, Mikey, to tell you. So maybe he'll be able to tell his girlfriend that's heartbroken.
Okay. Like,
he came and he gave this message, and he really wanted to give the message and tell her that he still loves her, he always will. And although he's there, he is going to meet her when it's her time, but he wants her to live her life here first, you know? And he has a tremendous amount of love with that, and a tremendous amount of emotion. And I feel that, you know, that's very important to say. Alan's saying to him, look, come on in, Mikey, we gotta go, you can't stay too long. But they're real happy that you're here tonight, though. I mean, your dad, right, Alan, you tried to speak to him before he went. You were to speaking to him as he went. As he went, I feel you talking to him. And he was hearing every word you said. It's like he was, you know, I know, even he couldn't reply back, but he could hear every word you said. And he wants to thank you for that. He knows you love him, and he could feel you holding his hand as well, you know, so... Yeah, that's it. It hasn't been very long, so it's a little bit sort of raw and emotional at the moment. But both of them love you, but they're together over the other side with other family members, and there's another older lady here keeping their eye on them, as if to say, you know, I won't let them get into trouble over here, because you might think they probably would if it wasn't for me. And that's what she's saying. So I'm going to leave that with you, but thank you for that. Thank you. All right, so... Yes.
So I'm wondering if she has any advice, because I'm not hearing anything.
Yes, you need to concentrate on your meditation deliberately. A mantra would be best to get down to one thought, and then after a few months of practicing, 2-3 months, you have, it takes at least 40 days of practicing the mantra, and then every day, and then after that, go on to meditation with no mantra, and you'll start getting messages, little messages you should write down afterwards. Always, when you get the little pictures and messages, thank them for it, because they then know that they've got through, and then they'll think, right, we can give us some more. So you need to do those two things, okay?
Thank you.
And that's with anybody, really. That's how to connect with spirit. Yeah.
Hi, my mother just recently passed about 3 months ago, and I have 5 children. I was just wondering.
Okay, take your time.
Always in my dreams. They're always in my children's, and she's touching them throughout the night.
Yes.
Is that her?
It is her, yes. After tonight, she will be less physical because she's been desperate to let you know that she's okay and she's on the other side and that she can see you, she can see the children, and that she just wants them to know that she's there. But she won't keep, you know, like waking them, because she's been doing that because she's been desperate to come through. And you know, she knows you've been desperate to get a connection from her, you know. As I don't know, the song you're wearing of hers tonight, is it? Yeah.
All of it.
All of it, right. Well, that's good. She knows you're representing her materially by wearing the jewellery, and she just wants you to know that from now on she's more peaceful in mind, because she knows that she doesn't have to keep trying to wake you all up to tell you that she's thinking about you. But she's emotional too, she's crying a little bit, so I don't think she's going to say too much, but she loves you and just wants to give you a big hug, and she wants to kiss the children and tell you, you know, thank you for coming tonight, so she could just let you know what she wanted to say. Thank you. God bless you.
If I do have a past life, what was I?
Right. Instantly. I know this one gets picked up a lot, but instantly I'm seeing ancient Egypt. Instantly.
I felt that.
You've got some artifacts, like bits of, you know, like pyramids or crystals or things like that, right? That you've already got from that area. There's another soul connection on the present day level that also was connected with ancient Egypt. And they will talk to you about it and want you to go on some sort of trip with them at some point. And I'm not sure whether it's to that part of the world, but eventually I think you will go. You'll have the strangest of feelings if you go, because you will just feel like you know almost what's written on the walls, you know, a strange feeling. You're an old soul, 7 different lives, but that's really only one. Okay?
Thank you.
Hi. I recently lost my brother, and I was wondering if you see anything, you know, if he's doing all right.
Was your brother a bit of a loner, the kind of person that sort of, you know, like, didn't have too much to do with anybody else, really? He did things his own way.
Yes.
Because I feel that he's a loner, because I was walking a bit then, because he's like, he's doing what I do. It's like he's been here all night, he's walking around on the stage as if to say, well, I don't know whether I'm going to say anything, but if I do, it's going to be my way and when I want to say it, you know. And he's saying, if you can't hear me, that's your fault, I don't care. You know? Is that like him?
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Because he's that kind of a personality. You know what, though, he loved you to bits. He never had a very good way of showing it, but he definitely did. He's saying he regrets not buying you stuff like Christmas and stuff like that, and birthdays and stuff, right? Because he's saying, at least that might prove something. But he's saying, even though I can't keep still, I am here tonight. And he's saying, you know, maybe, you know, at some point, I'll be able to come to you directly, he's saying. He's saying, what if you left the keys? The keys, you know. So he can't find his way in somewhere, but he's been trying to find his way. He's been to a place where he lived and the door's locked and he can't open it.
Uh-huh.
And I'm here to tell him, you don't have to open doors no more, you can walk through it.
And he's seen a funny side of that. And Achim said, okay, right, then I suppose next time, you know. He loves you, big hug, and he'll again speak to you again. He's still walking, he's making me walk. Okay, so.
Good evening, how are you?
Good evening.
I have a daughter that's passed on the other side, right. And I'm wondering if she has any message for myself and my daughter that's here.
All right. Was it an unstoppable health scenario? You know, there's nothing you could have done over a long period of time. You tried to struggle and fought, and she was such a fighter. I don't feel she was very big, but she fought very hard. She's here, I hear music, but she's not on her own. It's like somebody else she's dancing with, you know. It's like she's got so much energy. It's like, is it time to speak yet? You know, because I don't want to stop dancing and all that over here if it's not time yet. And then I think she's suddenly realizing it's a dad, you know. The feeling is like a run, skip, and a jump. You know, like she wants to put her arms around you. And her sister, she's saying something about being in, she sounds like she's saying, get out of my bed or something. she knows what I mean by that. She said, had she have lived, she would have been really into music and musician. She could have played things and she had like talents that she didn't have time to do. She loves the way you've done things in a place of rest. You've got to make a beautiful little place for her there. And she's saying, but you know what, Dad? I'm not there. She's saying, I'm at home with you and all the rest of them. And she wants you to know that. She got a brother too?
Probably a few on the other side.
Yeah, because there's other people, maybe they're the ones that she's playing or dancing with and having fun with on the other side. She's telling me she knows you did everything and more than you could. Did you, at one point, was you talking about giving blood or something? She's trying to tell me about that.
Yes.
Because she's saying to me, he did everything he could, you know. And she's saying, kind of big. She's saying she couldn't wish for a better dad. You know? I don't leave that with you too much, right? She loves you, and your sister, right?
So my father passed away 20 years ago, and my mom 2 years ago. But before my mom passed, moments before she passed, she was talking to my dad and said, I'm coming, wait for me. I'll be there, wait for me. And then she died.
Yeah.
So have you ever heard of people talking to the other side before they pass?
Absolutely. This is very common. In fact, you know, some people when they get older, they drift into spirit in the sleep state and come back again. You know, I've had people saying to me, oh, he's there.
He comes to me often.
Yeah, because you know what? He's determined. He's absolutely determined to let you know, because he feels a bit like, because he went youngish, like a bit like you missed out.
Yes.
And he knows you felt that a bit. You've come to terms a lot with it now, but he knows you felt that.
Yes.
And he's telling me that, you know what, some of the dads are saying, even though they're there, spend less time together than we have, even though I'm over here. He's saying we always have that bond, always have that connection. There's someone with him who looks a bit like you and maybe was like a brother with his or something.
His brother has.
Yes, right, his brother. But he looks a little bit like you. And he's saying, at least, he's saying, I've got some family to kick about with, he's saying. He's telling me that he liked to do things the old-fashioned way. He was down to earth. Everything was straightforward. He was a very hard worker. Too hard a worker, he's saying. He didn't have enough time with his family as he wanted to have. He's saying, when he looks back now, he said he doesn't know. If he'd have known, he's saying he would have done things a bit different, but who knows, he's saying, who knows. There's a David, I think he's trying to give me as a name, you know. Somebody else he's met in spirit. So I don't know whether that was a work colleague, but he had some good friends.
Right.
And some real good friends, but might be a bit far back to remember that. I have to tell you that he just wanted to give you that message tonight. and he wants to tell you he's very proud of you. And if you hadn't been here tonight, he's saying he doesn't know what you would have had to have done in order to get your attention. And he's saying something, he's saying. And he's like, he wants to, I don't know, sort of like a high five, maybe, like a bam, you know, thank you. Yeah, thank you. See you soon, Sammy Sue. Alright, so let me see. And he wants to tell you he's very proud of you. And if you hadn't been here tonight, he's saying he doesn't know what you'd have had to have done in order to get your attention. And he's saying something, he's saying. And he's like, he wants to, I don't know, sort of like a high five, maybe, like a bam, you know, thank you. Yeah, thank you. See you soon, Sammy Sue. Alright, so let me see. But I'm sort of getting there. I'm getting someone to do with motorcycles and the name of Michael. Is this over here? Yeah? Did you lose someone of the name of Michael in a motorcycle? Michael?
Yes.
Yeah, this is this lady here. So, right. Yeah? So, he's a family member of yours, right?
Yes.
Is he like a son or something? I can't quite get the...
Brother,
yeah. But it's been a lot of years. So they naturally have a better understanding of intuition and that sort of thing. So that's why there's more women here than men. But on average, you know, I mean, if there were more men, I would pick them. But now, for the how I get to choose people, I see a little light, white light bobbing around, and I follow that light, and that's my spirit guide telling me who to go to, and then the energy and the messages or the names start to come, and that's how I do it. Thank you.
Hi, regarding suicide, those who take their lives, are they destined to not find heaven or go to hell?
You know, I've heard this said many times, and it's a kind of a worrying prospect to think of it like that, and that's not really true. One thing I've found from people that have connected with me that have taken their own lives is they always feel very, emotional and concerned that they've hurt family so much. So they get hesitant to come through. But, you know, we all have a destined time. And if it's not your time, you don't go. There's many people that try and take their own lives that don't. Some people fall from aeroplanes and they survive. And some people trip in the street and they go. So it isn't, you know, it's considered to be a simple thing to take your own life. But the reality is, if it's not your time, you don't go anyway. But it's just, often people come through and they say, look, if I hadn't gone that way, it would have been another.
Would they, the thing about finding Spirit and God, are they destined to not, like, the stigma with taking your life?
No, it's not true. No, where we actually go to is created by the vibration that you create on the earth plane. So if you're a good person here, and most of the people that take their lives are very good people, they're very sensitive, and there's such an emotional place they can't cope anymore. Sometimes it's because their fear hurting everybody else, so they've got to go. But we go to the vibration that we create, and that's subject to one of the fundamental laws of the universe. Like energy attracts like energy. It's part of, you know, quantum physics and so on. So it's a factual thing. So we go to the vibration that we create when we're here. So if we're a good person, if you're over there, it doesn't matter how you got there, you will go to the vibration you've created. Okay? Thank you. Yeah, so that's a good question. Now, you know, some of the people agonize about it. It's okay.
First, I want to say thank you.
Thank you.
So I have two boys.
Yeah.
My youngest has always been on the radar, always in trouble, and we've always worried about him. My oldest is the one who I'm actually asking about.
Yeah.
And how is he?
So he's not in trouble. He doesn't. The older one's quieter. And,
very much so. Yeah. But there's still worry.
Yeah. Is he rather a solitude? You know, does he stay on his own a lot?
Yes.
He's sort of.
He was such a hard worker that he was restricted. You know, even though it's a very free place to live in, he was restricted materially. But you were like the apple of his eye, you know? And there's a photograph of you sitting on his knee somewhere that he's trying to show to me when he was really small. And he's telling me two birthdays very close together. Is it yours and his?
Mine and my younger sister's are coming up.
Right, because he's telling me about your two birthdays. Yeah. Even though he's here over on the, he's over here in the spirit world, he's not forgetting you over here. And he hasn't forgot your birthdays, and he wants it to be like a big hug and to tell you he'll be with you extra specially this year. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.
So we just had our reading with Bernard, actually mediumed our father, who just passed away 8 months ago. It was awesome. It was amazing. I highly recommend it. Bernard knew things. Actually, he channeled my dad, basically. And he had his mannerisms, his euphemisms, little details.
Gestures
that you... Yeah, it was my dad. Yeah, so that's...
Things about things that, you know, if you're skeptical, that he couldn't possibly have known in advance, and it was just very comforting to connect with him, because people have questions after you lose someone you love, and to know that they're with you and love you is just beyond comforting.
So, Bernard said my father was in the room, and that he was toasting me like this. And saying, congratulations for all your success, son. And the glass that he had apparently had a gold rim around it with letters that didn't spell any words anywhere along the way. So a week later, my mother was with me and she said, oh, Bernard was here. I said, yeah, did he say anything interesting? I said, well, I'll go back and I'll listen to the recording. And it's very important that you all go back and listen to the recording. Very important. There's all kinds of good stuff in there. Anyhow, so
don't pick your nose in the recording.
I wasn't picking my nose.
I was a good.